The Iglesia Ni Cristo Church of Christ was registered with the government of the Philippines on July 27, 1914. And more than a century later, it continues to grow and flourish. Expanding across six continents, the church has achieved extraordinary global success despite the world events that affect all walks of life. Though there were restrictions on large gatherings due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the Church of Christ did not stop worshiping God. Household worship services were conducted. The church continues striving to do what pleases God, no matter the situation. Though there were restrictions on large gatherings due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the Church of Christ did not stop worshiping God. Household worship services were conducted. The church continues striving to do what pleases God, no matter the situation. Travel restrictions were imposed, which hindered Brother Eduardo V. Manalo from seeing the brethren face to face. While this did not stop Brother Eduardo V. Manalo from conducting live streaming worship services, out of love and concern for the church members, he wanted to see them face to face.
Panahong yon, dahil nga sa halos may mga ipinatutupad na lockdown, may mga restriction, ay nakapag-uusap kami ng kapatid na Eduardo Manalo. Ang sabi niya, sabik na sabik siyang makita ang mga kapatid na personal. Madalaw sila. Makumusta yung kanilang kalagayan. Kaya nga lang, dahil nga sa restriction, hindi niya magawa. Pero mararamdaman natin na kung paanong nananabik ang iglesia na muli siyang makadaupala, ganun din ang kanyang pananabik higit pa na makadaupalan ang mga kapatid. Kailanman, hindi nawawagli sa kanyang alaala ang mga kapatid.
Before 2022, there were times when the restrictions for gatherings were lifted for a certain percentage of attendees.
Totoo ang napakatindi ng epekto ng pandemya. Noong magbukas at may sasagawa na yung pagsamba sa mga sa loob ng mga gusaling sambahan, ang isa naming nakita na bagamat ang ating mga kapatid ay dumaan sa ganung matitinding sitwasyon, kitang-kita mo yung pananabik sa kanila na makadalo ng mga pagsamba. Yung ganap na paghahangad na dun sa pagdalo nila sa pagsamba, makakuha sila ng inspirasyon, dun sila humuhugot ng lakas, sapagkat yun naman ang aral na itinuro sa atin ng pamamahala batay sa mga salita ng Diyos na nakasulat sa Biblia, na doon sa loob ng gusaling sambahan, sa pagsamba, nakikinig ang Diyos sa ating mga panalangin, nagpapalakas siya.
In many of the live streaming worship services, houses of worship were dedicated to God. Newly ordained ministers were added to the church. Weeks after the inauguration of the EVM Convention Center in Quezon City, Philippines, on April 1, 2022, the first pastoral visit of the executive minister to a house of worship since the lockdown was conducted. eager to see the brethren face to face. The executive minister continued his pastoral visitation. In 2023, Brother Eduardo conducted pastoral visitations outside the Philippines. On July 21, 2023, in a Thanksgiving worship service to God, in commemoration of the 109th anniversary of the Church, two houses of worship in Japan were dedicated to God in the local congregations of Gifu West and Ichikawa. This worship service was also live-streamed to different parts of the world, notably in the state of Hawaii and California, as the Church also commemorated 55 years in the West. This was followed by a large evangelical mission held in the Philippine arena. Works of propagation further intensified. Evangelical missions were officiated by the coordinator of the Christian Family Organizations, Brother Angelo Eranio V. Manon. As the Church continues to grow, it prepares to reach its 110th anniversary. But there are trials that affect both people of the world and Church members alike.
Take a drive down Los Angeles' Skid Row, filled with tents, people, and growing frustration.
Again in Bangladesh, where the government has shut down all public and private universities indefinitely.
The 2,000 families are at risk of losing the city's help paying their rent. They fear they're going to be back on the streets because the rent in D.C. is so high, and they're just struggling to make ends meet.
When American was asked what are they worried about economically speaking, it was pretty much tied between hunger and homelessness, economy, and availability of healthcare and housing, which is very telling for a first world country.
Flash floods and landslides occurred amid heavy rains.
This frustration over more than a million scorched acres, only matching fatigue from another firefight.
Hawaii, where wildfires have killed at least six people.
The death toll has risen to at least 10 across the Caribbean and is widely expected to rise.
The epicenter was located east of the coastal city of Antofagasta.
The Philippines' capital region has been placed under a state of calamity as non-stop rains from Typhoon Carina submerged parts of Metro Manila.
And as John Lawrence reports, the number of gun incidents in 2023 have hit a high not seen in the last decade.
Has knocked critical computer infrastructure offline all across the country and, in fact, all around the world.
Following diagnosis, they found an increased rate of depression up by 39%.
I mean, things like COVID, for example, natural disasters, you know, losses in life. These are life experiences that tend to shake the foundations of people's safety. Throughout the world, consistent results show that there's more depression and more anxiety as a result of the pandemic, especially the lockdowns. And I think disproportionately impacted or negatively impacted were our young people.
Despite the success that the Church has reached, like many people in the world today, members of the Church of Christ also experience problems.
When it comes to the situation of the world today, we can see that this world, it's really not a playground, it is a battleground. Our presiding elder, Brother Eduardo Manalo, makes sure that God's message is fully known throughout the Church. That's the light that we have. That's what guides all the members, whatever situation we're facing.
Because as members of the Church of Christ, the real future that we're hoping for is the future of receiving salvation and everlasting life.
Our executive minister is so constant in telling us to dedicate ourselves in performing our various duties in the church. He also teaches us, based on Scripture, the importance of our devotional prayers to God so that we can overcome the trials we encounter in life.
We attend the worship services at least twice every week. We continue to receive God's guidance, counsel, advices. We know that when we are able to please and glorify God, that is when the blessings will flow in our lives.
As the world situation intensifies in difficulty, it serves as a source of strength and resilience for the Church of Christ members because we learn to put our strong hope in God and that we will continue to praise Him faithfully no matter what happens around us. We don't quit. We don't give up. We do not lose hope.
God shows that no matter what the situation, He brings victory to His people, and that's the history of the Church of Christ. So when we look at the different challenges the church has faced, we can see that for every challenge, we have one place to oversee the entire church to administer, beginning with Brother Felix Manalo.
He began preaching the gospel. He was all by himself. People persecuted him. They would say all kinds of bad things about him.
One man whom by human standards, by human measurements, you'd say he would be considered helpless. He didn't come from the upper strata of society. He didn't have people in positions of power to help him. The church began in a poor country. 1914, at the same day as the outbreak of the First World War, the official beginning of the Church of Christ.
During the pioneering years of the church, world events such as the Spanish flu pandemic and World War II also affected the church members.
But that's where God's promise comes in the prophecy about His sending a messenger, where the Lord God Himself said, "You are my servant, I am your God, I will help you. Don't be afraid, I will help you." And that's what we see also why Brother Felix Manalo was so successful in his God-given mission. Because in holding on to God's promises, he was also holding on to preaching God's words, but also you can see that deep desire, that love for God, to follow God, to know that God's ways are all righteous, with that aim to please God.
Nung panahon na sumibo lang INC noong 1914, ang dami niyang kasabay ng mga religious groups. Ito yung panahon na ang daming nag-usbong na kung ano-ano mga grupo. Pero ang tanong, magsasurvive ba kayo? Kasi pagkamatay ng mga founders, nagpatayan din yung mga simbahan. Pero ang INC, since 1914, nag-prosper siya gradually. No? Nakita natin sa kasaysayan na lumakas ng lumakas, dumami na dumami ang miyembro. Yung unang 50 taon ng INC, makikita natin na libo na yung mga pinatay, yung mga katedral.
Nung namatay ang Ka-Felix, isang taon nito bago ang 50 taong anibersaryo ng Iglesia. So sabi ngayon ng mga kritiko ng Iglesia Ni Cristo, pag namatay ang kanilang sugo, babagsak na ang Iglesia. Dito mo makikita na agad at umaksyon ang bagong tagapamahalang pangkalatan, si Ka-Eranio Manalo, Ka-Erby.
Sa pamamahala ng tapatid na Eranio Manalo, nagsimula yung pagpapalaganap natin sa Ibayong Dagat. 1968, nagsimula sa Hawaii, pagkatapos doon sa California, ng Estado ng Amerika. Yun ang pinakasimula na lumaganap ng lumaganap ang Iglesia sa iba't ibang panig ng daigdig.
Isa sa controversial na yugto o panahon sa ating kasaysayan bilang mga Pilipino ay yung pag-iral ng batas militar. September 1972, na-declare ng martial law, pero tunoy pa rin ang pananambahan ng mga Pilipino. Tunoy pa rin ang pagpapractice ng kanilang pananampalataya. Pero wala akong nabalitaan na natigil na pagsamba. Ang mga kapatid, kahit saang dako, sa oras at araw na itinakda ng pamamahala na meron tayong pagsamba sa Diyos at sa ating Panginoong Kristo, patuloy ang pagsamba.
Brother Orlando Manalo was administering the Church of Christ, and as it started to reach different parts of the world, that no matter where the church reached, he would always teach the Church of Christ members, whether they're in the United States, Canada, Australia, Europe, the different places the church had reached during his time. Whatever the people around might be holding on to, whatever might be pleasing the people, he taught the Church of Christ, hold on to God's words, carefully follow God's ways, and do what pleases the one true God our Father.
Kung titignan mo, yung paglago ng Iglesia Ni Cristo ay pwede nating i-credit sa, well, of course, liban sa Panginoong Diyos kung ikaw ay naniniwala, ikaw ay believer. Pero bilang isang historiador, bilang isang topologo, tinitignan ko yan na may dalawang sangkap. Yung bayan, ibig sabihin, yung mga kasapi ng Iglesia Ni Cristo, at yung pinuno, yung pamunuan. Bakit? Una sa lahat, masigasig ang bayan. Masigasig dahil ikinakalat. Tapos, makikita rin yung bayan yan. Yung pangalawa naman, yung pamunuan. Kumbaga, ang isang samahan is as good as its leadership. Kailangan makita ng mga Pilipino ang ehemplo ng Iglesia kung paano sila nagbubuo at nananatiling matatag bilang isang leksyon kung paano rin pwedeng maging matatag at mabuo ang kabansahan.
And as the world changes, the church faces a new set of challenges.
Ukraine is now a nation at war.
An underwater volcano has erupted in the Pacific island nation of Tonga.
Extremely dangerous Cat 4 storm.
The landslides and severe flooding.
In recent years, there have been numerous global challenges.
Israel has formally declared war after that unprecedented multi-pronged terror attack from Hamas.
Despite the extraordinary events that happened around the world, calamities, and even despite the pandemic, God continued to grant victories to His church.
As the executive minister of the Church of Christ, Brother Eduardo Manalo continues to teach that message to God's people, that we are the people of God. The people of God continue to please our God.
During the time of Brother Eduardo V. Manalo now, the Christian family organizations were intensified, enhanced, all the more made stronger. Many more activities were created, established to build the faith of the brethren, to unite the brethren in doing things that please God.
The church continues to hold on to God's words. That's all the more what the entire church celebrated in 2014 with the centennial of the church 10 years ago. It's hard to believe it's been 10 years now, where we'll also now soon be remembering as well the 10 years of the inauguration of the Philippine Arena. In the very place where that gathering of God's people, the first worship service in Eva Beach, Hawaii, back in 1968, 50 years later, the executive minister, Brother Eduardo Manalo, was officiating a special worship service in the magnificent house of worship
in Eva Beach. And in that beautiful building of worship for God's glory, there's an ordination of 50 ministers who are coming from different parts outside the Philippines, mostly from the U.S. And speaking about church anniversaries, it was also in London just recently, last year, September, in celebrating the church's 50 years in Europe. Brethren from the 9 different ecclesiastical districts comprising about 40 different countries were gathered once again for an ordination of ministers who came from that part of the world.
The number of ministers grew so fast, exponentially. The influx of new members is unstoppable. The number of houses of worship all over the world continue to multiply.
The FYM Foundation has and continues to conduct community outreach events, especially the Care for Humanity.
We need the Church of Christ because they make our community better.
You're our neighbors, and you contribute so much to the fabric of our province.
I'm thankful and appreciative of what initiatives the Church is taking for our people.
Ang Iglesia Ni Cristo ay nakatalatag na sa 166 countries and territories na binubuo ng 152 iba't ibang uri ng nasyonalidad. At ang lahat ng ito, gawa ng makapangyarihang kamay ng Panginoong Diyos. Pagtupad ng Diyos sa kanyang pangako, sa sugo at sa pasugong ito, hanggang sa kasalukuyang pamamahay.
On July 27, 2024, the Church celebrates its 110th anniversary. To commemorate this milestone, the members of the Church of Christ all over the world render a Thanksgiving worship service. On July 19, 2024, Brother Eduardo Vimanalo led a Thanksgiving worship service to God and an ordination of new ministers in the Church's central temple in the Philippines.
We know that until Judgment Day comes, the anniversaries to come will be filled with even more blessings. In this last mission of salvation, we'll see that God will continue to listen to the prayers of His people. He'll continue to listen to the cries of His chosen ones, and He'll continue to grant His wonderful love to His people, because He can see His people are being taught and continue to embrace the message to please Him.
Kaya yun ang ating piliin. Magbigay tayo ng kasiyahan sa ating Panginoong Diyos.
sapagkat pagka binigyan natin ng Diyos ng kasiyahang inaasahan niya sa atin, ang sabi ng Biblia, yon ang magtatamo ng walang hanggang buhay pagdating ng araw ng paghukom. Mang kapatid, wala kaming ibang pinakahangad, kundi lahat kayo na napaanib sa loob ng Iglesia ni Cristo ay matamo ang kaligtasang pangako ng Diyos sa bawat isa sa atin. Ang totoo, siya ang unang-unang sabik na sabik na tayo ay makita niyang makararating doon sa bayang banal. Kaya nga niya tayo tinawag sa loob ng Iglesia. Kaya nga tayo binigyan ng kahalalan ng ating Panginoong Diyos. Sapagkat ang hanganin ng ating Panginoong Diyos, matamo natin yung kanyang mga pangako. Mga kapatid, kasi alam niyo kung bakit namin ipinagdidiinan ito. Nais namin maging malapit kayo sa ating Panginoong Diyos. Kasi uulitin ko, hindi na pangkaraniwan ang nagaganap sa daigdig. Hindi na pangkaraniwan ang nasasagupa nating mga pagsubok. Ibang klase na ang mundo na ating ginagalawan. Napakaraming suliranin, napakaraming kaguluhan, napakaraming nangyayaring hindi pangkaraniwan. Paano tayo makalalampas? Sa lahat ng yan, nandito pa tayo sa daigdig. Kailangan natin ng tulong ng ating Panginoong Diyos. Pero papaano? Papaano natin matitiyak na yung tulong niyang yun, agad natin matatamo? Magbigay tayo ng kasiyahan sa Kanya.